new guaranteed basic income programs, otherwise known as monthly checks, in multiple different cities, and an update on the stimulus package now that we have the framework that was unveiled by the president earlier today. Let's get into it, as we have a lot to talk about in this video. But really quickly, thank you so much for watching. If you're new here, or if you haven't done so yet, make sure to hit the subscribe button right down below the video, as I'm here for you each and every day with all of the latest updates and maintaining my commitment to you and this community as a whole, which is to be here to help out every single day in any way that I possibly can through these videos. So again, thank you so much for watching. Subscribe down below and let's get into this right away. All right, so let's quickly talk about the stimulus package and give you a quick update on some of the things that progressed throughout the day today. So if you caught my video earlier this morning, I talked about how the president was out just a short time before that unveiling the official framework of this reconciliation bill, the big stimulus package we've been talking about for a few months now. Well, shortly after he unveiled that throughout the day today, we've actually been seeing a number of people out of Congress come out and say, what? What is this? This is not even what we wanted. So a lot of people are really kind of scratching their heads right now thinking, what is this thing even? They took out so many different things out of this bill, or they shaved them down so small, or they shaved down the time horizons. Many of these people are saying, this isn't even what we wanted. I don't even know what this thing is anymore. So it's coming in at $1.75 trillion, but yet it's like, totally not what everybody in Congress wanted. So it's almost like complete confusion across so many people in Congress right now, thinking, I don't even know what just happened. We got this framework, but yet it's not even what we've been calling on, and it's not even what we've been working on. So it's kind of interesting to see this whole thing play out throughout the course of the day. Now, the whole reason behind the unveiling of this bill earlier today was so that Nancy Pelosi would bring the bipartisan infrastructure bill to the floor for a final vote in the House today. Well, some people have been calling on Nancy, hey, it's time to bring it, let's do it. And Nancy didn't do it, and she will not be doing it based on how it's looking right now. So that was supposed to be going down today, and it's not happening. So highly doubtful it will be coming, simply because the progressives are still coming out saying, there's no way, you can bring it, but we're not voting for it. It's not going to happen, so it's not going to pass. So Nancy knows that it's not going to pass anyway, so why bring it, right? So wow, this whole thing has kind of fallen apart here over the last 24 or so hours. Kind of interesting. Now again, the bill is still on the table, it's still going forward, things like that, but it's kind of really turning into something else, right? It was supposed to come out as a fluffy little dog, and it's turning into a greasy pig. You know what I mean? I mean, obviously not really, but there's still some pretty good stuff in there, but it's kind of interesting how this whole thing is kind of transitioning into something different over just this short period of time now. However, just a short time ago, earlier today, many people in Congress were saying, where's the text? We want to see the text on this thing. We can't vote for it if we don't see the text. Well, sure enough, just a few hours ago, the text was finally released. Yeah, so now they have a chance to finally look at the text from this thing, because they were saying, I can't support something if I can't actually read the text and see what I'm voting for. There's no way that I can support it. So finally, the text was released. In fact, the House Rules Committee is actually going through that text right now. So actually, let me tell you this. They started going through it, the House Rules Committee, at 3 p.m. Eastern time. So realistically, they're not looking at it anymore, maybe right now as I record this video, but they were looking at it a short time ago. Now, this is the process where basically they open up the text and anything can be taken out or anything can be added in. Remember, it is usually now when they go through this final negotiation phase when you probably get a lot of back and forth, a lot of drama, and things get taken out, things get added in. This is kind of an intense time right now when they open up the text and they start going through it line by line, right? So, wow. Anyway, so that's kind of what's going on with the stimulus package today. Kind of interesting stuff. All right, let me run through these guaranteed basic income programs. Now, this is interesting. Yesterday, I brought you a video in talking about these two massive guaranteed basic income programs that were just approved. Well, check it out. Applications are opening for those tomorrow. But not only that, on the back of these two programs that were approved and applications starting tomorrow, we got a list of multiple different cities that are going to be starting programs very similar to these two. Whoa, seriously, as I've been saying for so long now, literally, these guaranteed basic income programs continue to pop up on a weekly basis. This week, we've seen a number of them. In fact, I'll go through that list of different cities here in just a second. Let me go through these two cities here that I talked about yesterday and let you know in case you're eligible or if you are in one of these cities, you might want to apply as these applications are opening tomorrow. All right, so Chicago, you're up. $31.5 million is allocated in the city of Chicago to send out $500 to residents. So if you're in Chicago, you might want to check out those applications tomorrow as you might be able to grab $500 per month ongoing. I think it said 2 years. Yeah, pretty nice stuff right there, right? All right. Los Angeles, I talked about you yesterday. Los Angeles is approved. $40 million is up for grabs between, I think they said 3,000 families are going to be getting $1,000 every month for the next year in Los Angeles. So if you're there, go ahead and check out those applications starting tomorrow. I imagine the application window will not be open all that long. Typically it's not. It's usually open for about a week or so generally on these programs, but you might want to get in there if you're located in those cities. All right, so let's run through this other list of cities that was like literally just announced within the same article where they said, hey, these cities are next up on the list, going to be announcing very similar guaranteed basic income programs. Now again, even though it's guaranteed basic income, it's not a guarantee that these cities will come through and actually do it. But these are apparently cities that are considering starting massive GBI programs, guaranteed basic income programs. All right, so the list is Denver, Colorado, Newark, Pittsburgh, San Francisco, and there's a couple others here, New Orleans, and Minneapolis. Yeah, so those ones are next up on the list right now as far as some GBI programs that are going to be starting. Now remember, these two that I just listed from Chicago and Los Angeles, $31.5 million and $40 million. The programs keep getting bigger and bigger and bigger. Just like I mentioned yesterday, that's one of the interesting takeaways that I've been noticing with these guaranteed basic income programs. When they originally started a year and a half ago, they were starting very small. $1 million, $1.5 million. You know, they'd choose maybe 100 families or 50 families or something like that, or individuals. Remember, individuals are also eligible, but they'd just choose a very small group of people and just send out these checks and just see like, huh, how's this working, right? Now these programs are getting into the thousands of people for each of these programs. So they just keep getting bigger and bigger. Seriously, it's not long until we're going to see these things all across, I mean, literally everywhere. It is every week we see these things popping up. So anyway, I want to keep bringing these to you because it's literally a no strings attached payment. I know we call them guaranteed basic income. It's literally a monthly stimulus check. Now, these checks are typically smaller than the stimulus checks that we've seen in the past, anywhere between $500 and $1,000, but they're ongoing, typically a minimum of 12 months, and a lot of times they go to 12 months, 24 months, maybe 3 years in some instances, and I've even seen one for 5 years. So yes, ongoing for a very long time. So anyway, I wanted to bring you the latest updates on those right there, those programs, as well as the latest update on the stimulus package. Now again, I'm probably pretty sure that things will continue to progress throughout the rest of the day today. I can't even imagine what we're going to see the rest of the day now that they have the official bill, like the official text. They have the text, right? So they have that. So it's interesting to see what's going to come out of this now that they have it and they're starting to go through it. And they're starting to negotiate this thing. So, of course, they've already been through the negotiation process, but it's a totally different negotiation process now that the papers are in the hands, right? Because now they have the chance to review what is actually in this. Up until then, it's just kind of been like hearsay, like, well, this is in here, this is in here, but now they can actually see what is in it, right? So, the paper, yeah. So anyway, hope this helps you out. Again, my commitment to you is to be here for you every single day, bringing all the latest updates as they're being released, as well as doing whatever I possibly can to advocate for you and to help you out during this time, especially when it comes to getting more money and or benefits that you might be eligible to receive. So again, thank you so much for your support. Subscribe down below, share this video or any others here on the channel with your friends, family, and social media, and feel free to go back and check out any of the other 1,700 videos. Thank you again. Enjoy your day. I'll catch you again a little bit later with another update.